and happy Onam to you.
Thank you very much. Am I audible? That would be the most common question everybody is asking, right?
Yeah.
So,
you can see also.
Thank you very much for the kind words. So I'm basically going to speak to you about cataract and TRD. This is a case. Happy all. So this is a 65-year-old man. There was a decrease of vision slowly progressing over the last 1 year in the right eye more than the left eye. And he's having no redness, pain, watering, no other symptoms per se. And he's diabetic on insulin for the last 20 years and hypertensive 15 years on treatment. And recently diagnosed to have kidney disease. So on local examination, his head posture was normal, orthophoric, no facial asymmetry, extraocular movements were normal. The right eye vision was not improving beyond 3/60 and left eye was improving to 6/12 and N18, he was able to read handwriting and larger headings in the newspapers. And both eyes, the anterior segment was the conjunctiva, cornea, anterior chamber, iris all normal. And the lens showed nuclear sclerosis grade 2 with cataract, PSC and cortical in both eyes. And there was no cells and IOP was normal and gonioscopy was open. This was the right eye and this was the left eye. There was PSC and almost an amber colored grade 2 nuclear sclerosis. Dilated fundus examination, slit lamp 90D examination showed that in the right eye, the media was hazy. Disc was not seen clearly because of a fibrovascular traction on top of the disc, which is going inferiorly. And there were some hard exudates, plaques, which was seen through that hazy media of cataract and retina seen hazily. Macula seemed to be attached, which was on ultrasonography, there was a slight lift up of that retina. And because the vision was 3/60 and there was cataract and traction retinal detachment involving the macula, even though it is starting from the disc, this was planned for surgical intervention. In the left eye, media was slightly hazy, but the vision, you should understand, it was 6/12. Disc and margins were well-defined and with normal cut disc ratio, arterial narrowing was present and fibrovascular proliferation was seen, superiorly. Okay. So the diagnosis was both eyes proliferative diabetic retinopathy, straightforward. Right eye was having traction retinal detachment, left eye having fibrovascular proliferation around the disc, both eyes immature senile cataracts, diabetes mellitus, hypertension, and early nephropathy. So the right eye underwent intraocular injection followed by a combined cataract surgery with vitreous surgery, and the vision improved from 3/60 to about 6/24. And in the left eye, cataract surgery was planned and PRP was done, and the patient was then lost to follow up and came back after 1.5 years with loss of vision in the left eye too. And that is a point of time when the right eye picture was taken here, postoperative picture. There was a PCO also, which was also accounting for about a one line drop in vision. And so at the end of 1.5 years, when the patient came like this with traction retinal detachment with a vision of 4/60, he was operated and now he has about 6/18 vision. So there are some other examples. Now this is a patient with 6/12. You can see that there is a traction, which is very near the macula, almost touching the macula, which is slightly pulling up on the macula. The cataract is very mild, 6/12 N8. It is planned for pan-retinal photocoagulation. And when you do pan-retinal photocoagulation in such patients with traction, we try to move away from the areas of traction. But then after 1 year, the vision fell down from 6/12 to 3/60 suddenly and operated and now at 6/24. And after cataract surgery, vision improved to 6/12 parts. Now there's another patient who had normal cataract with 2/60 with TRD, now back to 6/18 with oil and waiting for cataract surgery. If possible, I will do a silicone oil removal and then only plan a cataract surgery. This is again another patient with counting finger close to face, vitrectomy 6/36 with oil, post cataract surgery improved to 6/24. And this is again another patient with hand movements with traction retinal detachment and massive fibrovascularization, now 2/60 with combined surgery. So what I wanted to say is there will be different grades of cataract, right from, really immature, if you say there is cataract, yes, there is cataract. If there is no cataract, there is no cataract. To, moderate, grade 2 cataract with, PSC to white cataract. So the questions that we will discuss would be, one, is cataract a cause of loss of vision, like if cataract is causing about 2 or 3 lines drop in vision, then definitely it is significant, because proliferative diabetic retinopathy and traction retinal detachments are not like the usual, as we understood over the discussions. Prognosis on surgery for cataract, what is the prognosis for surgery for cataract? What is the prognosis for surgery of TRD? And what is the function of the underlying retina, even if we are going to settle the TRD? Should we observe now versus should we operate now? Cataract first or vitrectomy first? Or is it a combined surgery? Intravitreal injection before cataract surgery or before vitrectomy? Combined surgery or sequential surgery? Can silicone oil be removed in this case before cataract surgery? Or silicone oil should be retained in this case? That decides a lot on IOL power calculations also. And so IOL power calculations with silicone oil inside, or in cases in which we are going to remove silicone oil, these will be our discussion points. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Gopal, for raising further controversies. You can unmute.
I am not able to unshare. One second, sir. There is some problem here.
I'll just make it. You made a good improvement, and I think some patients after TRD surgery, if they even improve 360 or 6x60,
thanks.
I think I always say that we should do a LVA. Maybe most of the time they are one eye, and other have been lost with NVG. So I think many times ophthalmologists forget, or even the patients are not interested. But I think you have to counsel the patient and make sure they use LVA, and later they understand they can also read N18 or something like that.
So to discuss these patients, 5-6 questions which last slide Gopal had presented, I'll invite Saurav and Padmuja for making initial comments, then others can pitch in. Maybe Padmuja can start.
I think cataract with traction retinal detachment is a scenario where we should see which is the predominant pathology. So I would always be definitely comfortable, for example, if the cataract media is not hazy enough and I can actually perform traction detachment surgery repair comfortably and adequately, I would go for vitreoretinal surgery first, and then oil, if it is required, oil implantation. And then also is the question about silicone oil removal first or followed by cataract surgery. I think that is also very important to understand that when you remove the silicone oil removal, and you will, after that, sequentially cataract surgery, the studies and as well as the personal experience, those cases actually do better in terms of having accurate refractive calculation and avoiding too much refractive shifts in these patients. So that's how I consider. Of course, when it is a cataract surgery plus traction retinal detachment is required because of the dense cataract, then again, it all depends on how your backup cataract surgeon is available. Like, for example, I do predominantly vitreoretinal surgery, and I want something, a good view for achieving my traction detachment. So I would actually prefer a cataract surgery first, followed by in 1 week time or something, where I could see the view, everything clear, and then I go for the vitreoretinal surgery. Because that is very important, because these are complex surgeries, and the time taken for the duration of surgery also can be prolonged when you combine the surgeries. So it all depends on how comfortable you are doing performing both cataract as well as vitreoretinal surgery at the same time.
Shalabh, can you add anything to this?
I would only quote Gopal's first patient, where the right eye had a TRD with vitreous hemorrhage. I would insist on the other eye having PRP first.
Yeah.
Because that patient did well in the right eye, went away. I would insist to all our cataract colleagues, the eye which is already gone, hold on for 2-3 weeks. Nothing will happen further into 3 weeks' time. Look at the other eye very, very carefully. Do a FA there if you're not confident. Less cataract. If you don't find any NV and VD, do an FA. Treat the eye PRP if possible, if necessary. Then come back to this eye first. Otherwise, I agree with whatever Padma said.
So this message is very well taken, that suppose patient has TRD or advanced disease in one eye, at least save the other eye by good PRP or whatever injections or combination thereof. So any other comment from anybody about this TRD? Because all TRDs may not require surgery. You see, the patient has good vision and the only eye with cataract, without cataract, so all TRDs may not require, because for TRD, vision is the main criteria for operating, because we have to ultimately improve the patient, not make it worse. So that is point number one. And yes, Nati, you were saying something?
No. George has some comments because yesterday also we had...
I am coming to George. I am going, not going to leave him, for, because a lot of comments I have to take from him. He has to leave now?
He's there.
Yeah. Yes, Partho.
Yeah, again, from the cataract surgeon's point of view, sir, if the cataract is moderate, well, good view of the fundus there and TRD is there.
Yeah.
So in these cases, if only vitrectomy and vitrectomy is done, then even then the cataract is going to deteriorate faster than otherwise.
It's okay. I agree. Like Padmaja said, if the media permits, I would definitely try to do the vitreous job, without cataract. And does not matter cataracts. After the retina is all set, TRD objective has been achieved, retina is stable. Then I would, take the help from cataract surgeon or refer him for cataract surgery. And I, for one, normally, Padmaja, try to combine both cataract, because a lot of biometry advances are now available. Optical biometries are there. Silicon oil mode is there. Most of the times, unless patient is going to record 6x6. In any case, you see, these patients are generally, by and large, you see bad TRDs, the 6x6 or 6x5, we are not looking. They're looking somewhere in between. So the accuracy and this thing, although biometers and silicon oil mode also are reasonably good. So I generally combine both SOR plus cataract so as to give the benefit. Because operating cataract in a fluid filled eye also poses challenges.
Yeah.
Yes, Santosh.
Sir, I would like to.
In case of these advanced PDRs, bilateral advanced PDRs with TRDs, would it make sense combining cataract with vitrectomy, since we can ensure a proper anterior vitrectomy so that there's no further anterior hyaloid proliferation later? Because a cataract or any amount of cataract or a phakic lens can limit anterior vitrectomy and then further rebids, rebleeds, and maybe NVG later on in this compromised systemic conditions.
I'll ask also about this. The thing is, the one stage versus two stage or single stage, you see, depends on how much job you have to do and how much membrane surgery you have to do in the posterior part. If the job is, say, very mild, then combination is very good. If somehow the job, job has to be very extensive, then I would actually do a two-stage cataract surgery first, and then maybe let's have opinion from Dr. George Rocha about this scenario, what Santosh said. You see, combining...
In my place, I do like you are saying, I do first the cataract and I plan for 1 week to do the vitrectomy. It's very important to take the cataract, because if you don't take the cataract, you can't clean the vitreous base that can prevent us to have the vitreous base perforation in hard case. And if you have the cataract, it's hard to photocoagulate well the far periphery. And then I think that the good thing to do is first do cataract, and after that, give an intravitreal injection in 1 week to operate vitrectomy. And most of the time, try to do with gas, C2FA, not oil, because oil is not good for diabetic. Yeah. But if it's very hard case with many holes, sometimes, or the only eye, I do oil. But sometimes I prefer much more gas.
Giri, any addition to this?
Yeah, I think, everything has been covered well. I think all the points have been covered well. Probably you can just summarize everything together, and that should be,
So one last question from my side.
Yes,
sir. So one last question. Does PRP or an anti-VEGF increases the progression of cataract?
PRP, I'm not very sure. Anti-VEGFs multiple may, yes.
The take-home message would be to our candidates, no. Don't get confused by that.
Yeah.
I want to ask Dr. George one question. Can I?
Yes.
Sir, in the presence of no cataract, will you remove the lens if you are performing a traction retinal detachment surgery so that you are able to reach the periphery and do good PRP, try till the aura, etc.?
Yeah, it's a very good question. If the patient is young I try to keep the lens. But if the patient has more than 50 years, I used to, even with the clean lens, I try to remove, because this bad case of diabetes, the patient is not well controlled and cataract will come very fast. And then I take the lens. But if the guy is very young, like less than 50, I will try to preserve the lens.
Okay, I think the time has come to, you know, summarize everything, and I'll and say thanks to all of you. We had very, very extensive discussion and very, very nice presentations. And I'm sorry, Partho, we ran, you know, more than what you allotted to us. So hand over to Partho for a summary as well as thanks.
Thank you very much.